an ancient Indian rishi. Shall we go ahead to the questions?
Okay, Bhagavan. The first question is, Sri Bhagavan, how would you recommend stabilizing the still mind and the flowering heart while still working on our charges and awareness? And could you discuss practicing the awareness exercises you suggested, the increments of 7 minutes, seven times a day for 21 days straight to break the habit of the mind? This is more difficult than I imagined it would be. Would you please give us a strong blessing to help us with becoming more aware?
The questions clearly indicate that you have been working hard. I'm very, very happy with it. So now I will try to help you. So first of all, you have to have a clear understanding of the teachings. Because these are very subtle teachings, and it's somewhat difficult to clearly get to know what exactly they are talking about. But once you understand it, it's going to be very, very easy. Now, all that I'm trying to communicate to you is, there's nowhere to go. You have assumed that you will practice inner integrity, that you will be aware of something, and that you are going to achieve something, or you are going to get somewhere. That's not it at all. Your charges and be free of your charges. No. What we are telling is, the content is not important at all. The content could be anything. It could be anger, hatred, jealousy, fear, lust, whatever you want. It could be anything. It does not matter at all, because they are not contents of your mind. They are contents of collective consciousness. It's like a vast ocean on which the waves are arising and ceasing. So every moment, something arises, something ceases. It is not under your control at all. We are all connected, and even connected to ancient times. All that memory is still there. They are called the Akashic Records. Everything is flowing through us. And if you identify yourself with it, we call it the Anatma or some wrong identification. So it's all happening there. And your job or your function is just to see what's happening and just to be aware of what is going on. Now, you are imagining that if you become aware of jealousy, you will become free of jealousy. It is not at all that. The teaching says, if you are aware of jealousy, that is it, that's all. To be aware of it is joy. To be aware of it is freedom. Not that something is going to happen to jealousy. Not at all. The content is not important. It could be jealousy, it could be hatred, it could be lust, it could be anything. The question is, are you aware at that moment what is going on? Now, for a moment, jealousy might arise. It could cease. Now, first time when it arose, maybe you identified yourself with it. Then it went away. Then maybe after some time, it would come back. This time, if you are going to be aware of jealousy, that is the moment of awakening. You are awakened at that point in time. You are enlightened at that point in time. You might lose it a moment later. Maybe it will again come back. Maybe again you'll be aware of. Whenever you are aware, that is the first step, that is the last step. Awareness is not going to take you anywhere at all. Not at all. You're imagining that after that, you're going to get somewhere. No. The first step is the last step. That's all. There's no second step. So the content, whatever is happening inside, is of no consequence. If you are aware of it, there's tremendous joy. There's much more to talk. I would not talk about that because you would make it into a concept and you would try to get there. Again, the same mistake would happen. So you are on the right track. The only problem is you are trying to reach out and get somewhere. There's nowhere to go. Nothing at all. The charge is there. It's not a question of being free of the charge. Are you aware of the charge? That's all. It's not that you need a still mind. The mind is not at all still. The question is, are you aware the mind is not still? That's all. It's over. That is a still mind. If you are aware and see, oh my God, what happened? First step. And the next step is to say, oh my God, I'm saying, oh my God. You're condemned it. So the problem starts with the naming. The moment you say it's a charge, then what charge? When it came, the whole story comes. So you have to observe the fact that you are naming. The mind is constantly naming. If it stops naming, the mind has no role to play at all. It just put in some basket somewhere, it's lying there. So you have to observe this process of naming. That's all. Everything else automatically stops. You're just intensely aware. To be intensely aware is all that there is. You are living. You're in the moment. It's finished. There's nowhere to go. It's quite simple. It looks difficult. But with this understanding, go ahead. We'll soon get there. And I'll be giving you a very, very powerful blessing to help you out.
Thank you.
So I'm very, very happy you're applying and that you've gotten into difficulties. Now I'll bail you out now. Next question.